He is known as the Wizard of Omaha and considered to be one of the world's most successful investors. And for thousands of investors around the world, Warren Buffett has become their investment guru. Every year, through his letter to Berkshire Hathaway shareholders, the legendary investor offers his wisdom on anything from his rules for investing in stocks to the US and global economies or even Bitcoin. Specifically, he reflected on two small properties that he purchased long ago and offered some insights on real estate investment. One purchase involved a 400-hectare farm in Nebraska, which cost him $280,000 in 1986. The other purchase, which he made with a small group of investors a few years later, was a retail property in New York. The common theme in these tales was that he purchased both assets after property collapses. In his letter, Buffett says he cites the tales to illustrate certain fundamentals of investing. Warren Buffett then goes on to highlight his 7 rules real estate investors could learn. Before, please like and share the video, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell icon for more updates. Rule number 1. Show me the money. Warren Buffett's investment rules are remarkably consistent. They're best collated in Lawrence Cunningham's book, The Essays of Warren Buffett. When he's looking at a business, Buffett calculates the earnings yield. In other words, if a company is selling for $1 million, and its annual revenue, after expenses, is $100,000 a year, then the business yield is 10%, 100,000 divided by 1 million equals 0.10. When Buffett considers buying a business, he compares the earnings yield to that of a risk-free 10-year treasury bond. If the yield is much higher than a treasury bond, it piques his interest. By comparing investment yields, Buffett can compare one company to another. Investors should do the same with real estate too. Property yields can vary a lot. For example, consider two properties. They each cost $500,000. The renters in the first property pay $50,000 a year. That's a 10% yield. The renters in the second property pay $20,000 a year. That's just a 4% yield, which isn't much higher than the yield on a 10-year treasury bond. If the condition of the properties and the quality of the tenants were the same, the higher yielding property should look like a diamond next to a potato. Rule number 2. Do you know what could change the yield? In 1993, Warren Buffett bought some commercial real estate. He reveals the story in his 2013 letter to Berkshire Hathaway shareholders. The yield was 10%. He also knew that one of the tenants had signed a long-term contract at a low rent level. When that contract expired, the earnings yield would soar. The unleveraged current yield from the property was about 10%, he wrote. But the property had been undermanaged. And the largest tenant, who occupied around 20% of the project space, was paying rent of about $5 per foot, whereas other tenants averaged $70. The expiration of this bargain lease in 9 years was certain to provide a major boost to earnings. You might not be so lucky. But if several new businesses are moving into an area of interest, this might also boost rents, raising yields along with it. However, like Buffett did when he made his purchase, make sure any yield is already strong before you buy. Rule number 3. Avoid speculation when embracing location. Plenty of real estate investors focus on location, and for good reason. But Buffett says investors should focus more on earnings. In other words, a great location might mean you can attract great tenants and charge them a premium over a less desirable space. But if real estate investors want to follow Buffett's tenets, they shouldn't buy a property just because they think the price will rise. As Buffett wrote, if you focus on the prospective price change of a contemplated purchase, you are speculating. I am unable to speculate successfully, and I am skeptical of those who claim sustained success at doing so. Rule number 4. Buy and hold. Buffett says his favorite holding period is forever. Plenty of others trade stocks like feverish kids trading Pokemon cards. They might do well, short term, but over the long haul, such investors often see their luck run dry. It's much the same with properties. Unless you're especially skilled at buying and fixing, consider Buffett's way. When investors flip properties, it increases their risk. It also increases their transactional costs and their taxes. Rule number 5. It's about a billion razor blades. Berkshire Hathaway has been a longtime shareholder of Gillette. Buffett says he sleeps well knowing that when he goes to bed, millions of men grow whiskers overnight. When they wake up, many shave with Gillette. This means Gillette has multiple sources of revenue. Every person who shaves with Gillette adds to the company's sales. In contrast, if Buffett owned a company with just one customer, his risk would be higher and he wouldn't sleep as well. Such is the case with homes. That's why real estate tycoons buy commercial buildings instead of a gazillion single-family homes. A single-family home has just one source of revenue. In contrast, A duplex or triplex reduces risk. If one tenant moves or can't pay the rent, the others still provide revenue for the month. What's more, when all other factors are equal, multi-revenue properties tend to have higher earning yields. Rule number 6. Buy what you understand. Buffett buys businesses that are within his circle of competence. He and co-chairman, Charlie Munger, say it doesn't matter how big your circle of competence is, but you should stay within its bounds. For real estate investors, that means buying properties in places you understand. Do you know the location well? Do you know the tax laws? Do you know what types of tenants you can expect? Do you know what environmental or economic factors might decrease or challenge your annual revenue? Properties in a new mining town, or those in foreign countries like Thailand or Mexico, might look enticing. But if they're outside your circle of competence, you'll be taking higher risk. This brings us to Warren Buffett's most important investment rule. Rule number 7. Don't lose your money. Championship portfolios, whether they're real estate or stocks, are rarely the result of a single home run. We like sharing stories about a single hot stock, or how Johnny Lucky retired on a golden property pick. But most fortunes are built with a lot of common sense. If we stick to something sensible, like Warren Buffett does, we should see our profits soar. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. So kindly subscribe this channel, and click the bell icon for more updates.